for the information of the citizens of the state, again I would like to update the following information. Number one, the sample collected and sent for testing till today is 2,287. Reports received and treated as negative is 2,178. The number of test report awaiting is 96. Then active cases has increased one more, and that is 13. Then two active cases. As of today, there are two active cases. One deceased, 10 fully recovered, and two active cases. The one active cases, which I would like to clarify here, is we received a report today only. The report of yesterday's sample, we received it today in the afternoon. That one person again got positive report, and in fact health condition of this particular person is stable. She is okay. And the previous one also, which the report is positive, it is due again for retesting next Monday, means on the 11th, because every 3 days we have to again collect the samples. Then next Monday we are going to send again the samples in the morning, and by afternoon or evening we'll be able to get the report. And this newly infected person happens to be from the same source. Please write properly. Happens to be from the same source, meaning from the deceased source, and who happens also to be another maid servant. In fact, I just wanted to tell you, this maid servant, she did a quarantine immediately on the 14th of last month. In fact, that time 15-16, we, after collecting the samples, then we received the report on the 16th, she was tested negative. Again, we did another test, because see, government leave no stone unturned, because these are the primary contact. These are all high risk contact or primary contact. And we have altogether the high risk contact, or the primary contact, I should say, we do have 181 numbers. And all 181 numbers has been duly tested. And then today, unfortunately, one of the high risk or closed contact, primary contact, she got tested positive. And the person who got infection was also transferred to Corona Center in Civil Hospital. That is the point number one. And regarding the items like PPEs and then N95 mask, ply mask, I would like to update again. PPEs we received till today is 1,46,686. 95 N95 mask 1,38,726, and then 3-ply mast 6,30,000 is relating to those friends stranded students within the northeastern states. Till today, up to 2-3 o'clock, the total number of stranded students and friends working in different parts of northeastern states reaches to 2,623 till today afternoon. We do have again today evening and then tomorrow. I'm very sure maybe by tomorrow we'll be able to receive them all to our state. Information or some sort of appeal, I would like to inform all of you, and also to request all of you to kindly inform all the concerned citizens of Meghala for information and also immediate response. On the 7th, one case was found out in Guwahati Medical College Hospital who has been tested positive, and another one case reported death out of the COVID-19 in Dr. B. Barwa Kansa Institute, Guwahati. These are all hospitals from Guwahati. One is Guwahati Medical College, and number two is Dr. B. Barwa Kansa Institute, Guwahati. These two hospitals or these two institutions, I would like to request maybe some citizens of the state visited these two officers with effect from 23rd April. With effect from 23rd April this year, I would like to request all of them, not necessarily that they are direct contact or primary contact. Maybe it happens that they went down for medical treatment of their relative or whoever. So from the government side today, we decided to request them to kindly immediately call up 108. Those patients or those visitors who visited these two medical institutions in Guwahati. One is Guwahati Medical College, and the other one is Dr. Barwa Kansa Institute, should immediately register themselves in 108. And the moment they get them registered, government will take care of them, everything. We will follow it up once they registered under 108, and instruction also will be given to them accordingly. But they should not be panicky. That is my request. They should not be panicky. Be normal. Government is together with all of them, as I said to you. But my humble request is they need to immediately report or register in 108. But those patients only who, or those patients who visited to these two places, not necessarily whoever goes down to Guwahati should report, but only these two institutions. One is Guwahati Medical College, and number two is Barwa Kansa Institute. Only these two institutions, whoever visited from 23rd of April, may kindly register through 108, and thereafter government will be in touch with them on a regular basis. The next point that I would like to again inform the citizens of the state. Today in the review meeting we had under the chairmanship of the Honorable Chief Minister, we decided to have some more relaxation. In Shillong. Shillong agglomeration, we will, from Monday, we are going to open up auto shops, the automobile shops, okay? Number two, stationery shops. These are the two areas where we would like to again open up, but excluding Yeudo and Police Bazaar. Yeudo and Police Bazaar still shops will remain closed. But outside these two important places, it is allowed from Monday, and Deputy Commissioner will do the needful, including the regulation of the opening up of these two sectors shop. Number two, in rural areas, in other districts, because other districts they fall under green zone, from Monday, government is allowed that all shops be open. All types of shops from Monday will open, excluding Shillong agglomeration. Number two, public transportation. Last time we put in place with the total strength of 25%, and this time we increase it to 50%. We increase it to 50% from 25%, the public transport, and the addition decision that we taken today is even the private transport is allowed up to 50% outside Shillong agglomeration. All districts except Shillong agglomeration, 50% of private and 50% of public transportation will be allowed from next Monday, means from 11th of May 2020. And the protocols, regulations are now leave to the wisdom of the respective deputy commissioners to work it out on rotational basis. And we leave it to the wisdom of the deputy commissioners as well as the district transport officer.